don't know if I feel comfortable putting this on, cause girl.
Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, then hey, how you doing? Go ahead, make yourself comfortable because you family now. And if you haven't already, go ahead, make sure you hit that like button as well as the subscribe button. That way you can catch me every time I do post. In this video today, I'm going to share with you some new lipsticks that MAC just came out with. And honestly, girl, it's a whole new collection. So if you didn't know anything about MAC already, which is just like where you've been living, baby, under a rock, MAC Cosmetics is known for a lot of great things, as well as their quality of makeup, Studio Fix Fluid, Studio Fix Powder is like their number one selling foundation. And they're the OGs of OGs when it comes to this beauty thing. They've been around and they're one of the top leading lipstick brands in the world. And if you don't believe me, you could Google that. I'm gonna share with you 17 new shades. Yeah, girl, you heard me right. 17 new shades, all from MAC Cosmetics. So go ahead, get comfortable, pour yourself up some wine, and get ready to take notes on your favorite colors, because I want to know down below in the comments, out of all the colors that I do put on, which one is your favorite one. If you aren't familiar with MAC lipsticks, then you should know that they categorize their lipsticks in different formulas. Based on the formula, the lipstick could look a lot different. And looking at it from the outside in, it could look like one color, but when you put it on, it looks like something else because of the formula. Those formulas are listed as Retro Matte in Bullet and Liquid, Matte, Satin, Cream Sheen, Luster Glass, which by the way is their newly reformulated lipstick, which is amazing by the way, Frost, Love Me Lipstick in Bullet as well as Liquid, and Powder Kiss in Bullet as well as Liquid. I could dive deep into the definitions of what each category is, but that's gonna be in a whole nother video. So if you're interested in seeing something like that, please hit the like button. That lets me know that you're interested in seeing that, and I will make a video like that explaining their formulas. So let's get into these lipsticks. I'm gonna talk about these lipsticks in three different sections. First, I'm gonna start off with this one that I have on, since I already have this on in the video. This one is called Sweet Deal. It is a matte lipstick. It looks just like this when you swatch it without the lip gloss, and I do have a lip gloss and a lip liner, but it looks just like this when you first apply it onto the lips. It's very full coverage, and I really like this lipstick honestly because it's so pretty. I paired this lipstick with a little bit of Beat lip liner with a little chestnut. I kind of like made my own concoction because that's just what I like to do. And I use see-through lip gloss on top. So the next lipstick that we're gonna try is Get the Hint. I like how the mattes feel very creamy for it to be a matte. It's super easy to just glide across my lips, and you know sometimes mattes could be, well, most likely most mattes are very drying on the lips, but this feel very comfortable. I just want to say that the color is not my type of color. It's a very vibrant pink type of color, and if you are a woman of color who is gonna decide to wear these type of lipsticks, please pair a lip liner. It is crucial in your lipstick application, and honestly it just makes everything look good. It also brings dimension to the lips so it doesn't look like this, and it just gives more of a nice finished look. So if I was to pair a lip liner with this, I would pair half red, and as you can see it looks better with the lip liner, just to give it a little something. But honestly, I should have put on my lip liner first before I put on the lipstick. Okay, the next lipstick that we're gonna do is called Come Over, and she is a really pretty pink as well. She looks just like this when you swatch her for the first time. Well, I like this pink, it's pretty. Well, this pink is almost like a powdered type of pink. She's cute. I definitely want to pair her with more of a brown lip liner, so I'm gonna use Cork, and I'm just gonna apply her on the edges of my lips just to get some dimension to the lips. I think this is one of my favorite ones for sure. She's definitely one of my favorite ones for sure. I love how soft It is. It's literally one of the most prettiest pinks I ever seen, honestly, in my on my skin tone. I really like the way she looks. Definitely rating her at the top. She's definitely at the top for mine. How y'all feel about it? I like this one already. This one is called Keep Dreaming. She's a very strawberry type of pink, but I like it. I would pair her with Beat Lip Liner for sure. Ooh, she is so freaking pretty. She pairs very well with Beat Lip Liner. She's just as creamy like all her other sisters, and she's really pretty. She's giving me very like fabulous, like one of those fabulous colors that's just like, oh, so pretty. Okay, the next color is Ring the Alarm, and she's beautiful as well. I would pair her with Beat Lip Liner as well. Oh, she is really pretty. This one is called Forever Curious, and she is so freaking pretty. I paired her with Half Red Lip Liner because I don't want her to look too chalky on the lips. So this is what she looks like. So now we're about to switch it up a little bit, and we're going over to the Amplify Cream Lipsticks. This one has a little bit more shine compared to the last lipsticks that we just tried. Amplify is pretty much still going to give you the same full coverage. It completely takes out the whole lip color in its full coverage. So this color that I'm about to wear now is called Dallas. She's really pretty. I like how she has like this red, I don't know how to explain her, but y'all see how she have that sheen to her compared to the matte. It's just completely matte. There's no shine. I would pair her with Beat Lip Liner as well because she is definitely more on the beat side with that pinky red undertone. Oh, she's fabulous. She like a magenta hot pink. I don't know if that even makes sense. Is that even a thing? But I love Amplified Line. It's literally like if matte and satin had baby with the luster or cream sheen. And if I didn't mention this already, which I should have mentioned, there's 6 matte lipsticks, and then there's 7 amplified lipsticks and 4 luster glass lipsticks. The next lipstick that I'm gonna try on is Just Curious. She is really pretty. She's so pretty. And I love how she has that shine. So I'm pairing her with Cork Lip Liner because I don't want the color to be taken away too much. I just need a little bit on my, I just need the edges to blend so it don't look like I slapped my face with donuts or pink, hot pink donut on top of that. It feels so creamy and just like buttery, so smooth. Wanna like, let me talk to you, boy. How you doing? No, I'm just playing. No, for real though, this is such a beautiful color, and I just love how MAC is getting us ready for spring. I know we're still in the winter time, but these colors is giving very much spring vibe. The next lipstick is gonna be Do Not Disturb. She's really pink. I don't know if I feel comfortable putting this on, cause girl, I'm gonna go ahead and line my lips up first, honestly, because I ain't, Oh, girl. She is pretty, but she is so pink. Like, oh, girl. She got like that lavender undertone to her, though. Girl, she giving snob. But I guess when you like blend her, girl, I will put a lip gloss on her. I don't know. What y'all think about this one? She cute, but she's very bright. Like, this is for my girls who like it real bright. I'm not that girl. She is bright. She is bright as my shirt. This isn't my type of lipstick, but she all right. How y'all feel about her? How do y'all feel about Miss Do Not Disturb? Okay, y'all still sticking along with me. We still got some more to go, so stay with me. This one is called So You. She's cute. She's very vibrant. I almost want to try her with Candy Yum Yum lip liner and see what it looked like. So I pair her with Candy Yum Yum. She's really pretty. I like her. Still not me, but tell me what you rate her below. The next lip color is gonna be Spill the Tea. Oh, she's real pretty. Come on, child, spill the tea. Oh, she's really pretty. I would definitely pair her with Cork Just Wondering. This one is really pretty. City. Just Wondering is very vibrant. It's so pretty, and you know what? The shine on it just makes it even more prettier. Oh my god, this one is probably like another one of my favorite ones, even though I'm typically not like a bright. This is something that I will wear. She is so pretty by herself. I love the way she just hugs my lips and feels so moisturizing, and the sheen is so pretty. It looks like I put a lip gloss on, but I haven't even put a lip gloss on or need to put a lip gloss on because she is just so pretty by herself alone. Like, you don't need anything else with her. Like, I'm not even about to play with her like that. She is not one of them. I just wanted to show y'all like how much it stained my lips. Like, look how much my lip is stained. Like, what? Okay, y'all, so we have one more left for the Amplify lipsticks. So far, I'm impressed with a lot of these lipsticks, like the formula, the way it feels, the way it stand on, the staining power. Like, I wasn't expecting for my lips to be stained throughout this video. Not like this. Okay, so the last lipstick for the Amplify formula is gonna be Lovers Only. She's really pretty too. She reminds me a lot like the last one. Let me swatch both of them together because I gotta see. So I'm gonna swatch the one I have on now on my hand with the last one because they kind of look similar to me. You know what? It is different. So the last one that we just tried, it was more vibrant compared to this one. It has more of like that red berry undertone, but it's still pink, as you can tell. Oh my god, my lips are like so sore. Now we're down to four more left. We're gonna move on to the Luster Glass, which is the very last category that we're gonna do today. It's one of the latest lines that, well, it's been around, it's just been reformulated. Like I said before, it's been reformulated and repackaged. It's very creamy, it's very shiny. It's almost as if you put like a lip gloss on top, but it's not as thick or sticky as some lip glosses are. So it has a very like lightweight texture feel to it. It's very balmy. Think of like a tinted chapstick, almost kind of like a tinted chapstick, but it has more shine to it than what a chapstick would be. So think of it like a tinted chapstick. It's more buildable coverage. It's not full coverage. Honestly, I wouldn't even say that it has the potential to go to a full coverage. Even if you continuously applied a lot on, the most I would categorize the Luster Glass is in a medium coverage. Let's get into that. The first color that I picked out is gonna be Oh Goody. Oh, she's really pretty. I like how she feels when you apply it. Like I said, she's gonna be more on that buildable medium coverage. She's not gonna give you a whole bunch, but she's definitely gonna give you shine. This one is called Frienda. I swear to God, I can't make this up. I like the name of this. She's pretty. I like the way she looks. This is Frienda. This is so pretty. I love the way she feels, especially since my lips are so like they were so irritated and so like hurting. I was like almost wanting to put on like some type of lip conditioner, but this literally soothes it. It just, it looks so pretty. I like this lipstick. All of the Luster Glass have this MAC symbol imprinted on them, but she feels wonderful on my lips. It almost feels like I have lip conditioner on. It feels so good. The next lipstick that we're gonna get into is called Cane Tail. That's a cute name. Ooh, she is so pretty and soft, and like, look at that. Oh, she feels so good and she's so pretty. This is one of my favorites out of this section. This one and Frienda. Can you tell? Like, can you tell? Can you tell? No, for real. Ooh, I like the way she feels, and I don't need a lip liner for her or a Frienda. I feel like with these, you don't really need a lip liner or anything because they're so sheer. It's just something that you can just pop on, except for the first one that we tried on. That one was a little bright. I like the way she feels. I love this color. I can't even talk about it too much. It looks good. It looks like a color that I would wear, just like an everyday type of color. When you want to do just enough, that's when I will pull her out. She even got me changing my hair look. Can you tell? Now, last but not least, drum roll. No photos. She pretty.
Honestly, all four of the luster glasses are my favorite ones so far. What I love so much about this formula and these colors is that you don't even need a lip liner with these. These are just like something that you just throw on and just, you know, you're gonna look cute with it. Like, you know you look good, okay? You don't even gotta worry about it. If it's just one of those nights where, you know, you just hopping off work, if you could just touch up your foundation or your concealer or your powder or whatever you put on and just pop this lipstick on, you don't have to worry about lip liner, lip primer and all the other stuff that goes along with applying a lipstick. You don't gotta worry about, oh, I need some gloss now because it's matte. You don't need that. She just gives off that glowy vibe. Okay, and that concludes this video. Which one of these colors was your favorite one out of all 17 lipsticks? I'm gonna say, from what I can remember, because my memory is no good, child. From what I can remember, definitely the four luster glasses were my favorite. I still have on a luster glass right now. What was your favorite one, though? Comment below, let me know, and which one you see yourself copping. So that concludes this video for today. Thank you so much for tuning in. Until later, deuces.